A momentary
break. As long
break.
As it's truly but a moment. Highly irregular, this.
Oh, everything is highly irregular about this.
Have you come to see how I fare? I'm fine, thank you. Artorias's ribbon worked wonders. It's a shame they took it from me.
I know who the fifth victim was supposed to be.
Goodness, you're simply a compulsive snoop. I'm in prison. Detloff is dead. Could you not just drop it?
Nope.
Sienna, stop pretending you couldn't care less. I know it's an act, and it's really starting to wear. Why do you want to kill her?
For such an accomplished investigator to ask about the obvious? Come now, Geralt. Why do you think?
Oh, I'm not a fan of... Oh, come on. Because she turned her back on you and forgot about you? Because you envy her. The way I'm thinking she's working, it's probably number three. Sort of number two too, but mainly number three. She seems to be very vengeful.
Because she turned her back on you, then banished all memory of you.
Bravo, Geralt. Yet another riddle solved, and your sick curiosity saved you.
It's not sick.
Well, what now? Off to share your discovery with Anna Henrietta. Oh, she's no longer in danger, true. But she very well might add a little something to your reward.
Definitely gonna tell her. Not necessarily for the coin, though.
Then why do it at all?
She ought to know. If only because you'll probably try to kill her again if she ever lets you out.
Yup, that's what I was thinking.
I probably will.
Fucking, and she admits it. I cannot believe that. She really is evil incarnate. Or not incarnate, evil maid. That's at least my opinion of the whole matter. Honestly, finally. Ever thought to forgive her?
Perhaps, just for a second, you could stop dwelling on all the wrongs folk have done you, and forgive her.
Why should I?
For old time's sake. You loved each other once.
Please. I don't know who fed you that rubbish, but...
Read your governess's diary. You played together, were inseparable. Henrietta'd get you into trouble sometimes, sure. But there were also times she stood up for you. When you had nightmares, only she could calm you. Time eats away at memories, distorts them. Sometimes we only remember the good, sometimes only the bad.
If she loved me so, why did she wash her hands of me? Forget me, hmm?
Well, you could ask her that, right? Just an idea. You know, so many problems could be solved with talking.
Don't know. But you could just ask her instead of sending monsters after her.
There's nothing she could say to change what she did to me, to justify it.
Maybe. But there's nothing out there to justify what you did to her and all Toussaint. Yet Anna Henrietta hasn't given up on you.
Ugh, you really want a happy ending, don't you?
Actually, I want you dead.
Ah, with all of us living happily ever after.
Except for you.
Go, Witcher, or they'll give your medal to another. And that would be a shame.
Farewell, Sienna.
I really hope they don't forgive her, ever. Because everything, just saying.
Commander de la Tour would like to see you. Shall we go at once?
What can I do if I say need to tend to something?
Need to tend to one thing first. I'll look in on them afterwards.
So be it.
Ooh. Talk to Damien! Damien! Oh, so I can potentially... Oh, look at that. What? There's a new quest available. Hell yeah. I'm coming. Why is there a new quest available? That doesn't make any sense. I thought we'd done away with everything. Haven't we? Why should there be a quest available now? Does that make any sense to anyone? Is that gonna be another side quest? It probably is, isn't it? I wonder if everyone, if anyone ever, you know, there's probably enough people who wondered whether or not there's still something to do and did it. But, ooh! I remember this dude.
Guillaume, what are you doing here?
Leave me be. Without my Vivian, life has no meaning. You are the last to whom I wish to speak.
Oh, come on. That's it? And for that, I went outside?
That's the butcher of Blaviken.
Yes, it is. Fuck off. Yeah, wait, that literally wasn't everything, right? That's not why I stopped. False to me. It apparently is. Fine. Should I just go to the Mère Lachelois cemetery? No. I'm gonna go there after the ceremony. Gonna go to the palace garden and then introduce ourselves inconspicuously into the ceremony. What the fuck did I just say? Inject ourselves inconspicuously into the ceremony? Which sort of doesn't work if we're an important part. Just attend it. It's probably the best if we ever just say, let's just attend the ceremony. Where the hell is that dude that we're supposed to talk to about? Oh, Damien. Damien, right? Where's Damien? There he is. Ooh, shit. Well, that's one time round the rosy. For nothing. What is this? Why is there a phoenix egg? What the hell is a phoenix egg? Did I just collect the phoenix egg? And why? Is another one of my questions. What does it do? What does it do? Well, apparently I can just sell it. Okay, fine. That's cool. So, Damien, what's up?
Damien.
Geralt, it's about time. Ready for the ceremony?
You look worse for the wear.
Your face doesn't look good. Though it looked even worse last I saw you.
I apply a balm of Arnica. Yeah, I hardly feel it anymore.
That's what you see. Should I tell him? Sure, I'm gonna tell him.
Got some important information. Anna Henrietta was supposed to be Detlof and Sienna's fifth victim.
You are certain of this?
Completely. Found proof.
Inconceivable. How could she? The murders, the mayhem she brought down on the city, were they not enough? She sought to strike down her own sister, her liege. Traitor. I must alert my men. Enlarge the Duchess's honor guard. Make certain Sylvia Anna is closely watched during the questioning. I'll see to it personally. I thank you, Witcher, for alerting me. And I appreciate your attentiveness.
Let's begin the ceremony. Come with me. The Duchess awaits.
The Duchess awaits. The ceremony.
In the guild's name, I beg your assistance, your enlightened highness. Without barrels, production will come to a stop, and it will be the end of us.
You lost them all in the fire. These are horrible tidings. Oh, we are most dreadfully saddened.
Yes, your enlightened highness, all. Once the beasts had clawed their way into the warehouse, the whole place went up in flames.
Is that woman behind her having red eyes?
I shall dispatch a palace guardsman to examine the site of the blaze. If things are, as you say, fitting compensation shall be paid from the ducal treasury.
Thank you, your enlightened highness.
That is super disturbing. All of them have red eyes.
Geralt of Rivia has arrived.
My dear subjects, we come now to our next point of business. Of all the duties which fall upon my shoulders, as the ruler of this dominion, this duty is dearest to my heart. For now, we shall award the Order of Vitis Vinifera, Toussaint's highest honor.
Geralt of Rivia, Slayer of the Beast of Beauclair, step forth.
We bestow the distinction upon the Witcher, who saved Beauclair from the terrible beast. Such is our desire.
Last action hero.
May this symbol serve as a reminder to all that the Witcher shall forever remain a friend of Beauclair.
Now we've got a place where we can sort of hide
in
if anything goes shit.
Terms now, I thank you immensely, Geralt. Damien has your reward for you. After all, it was but a contract.
Thank you.
I have a small surprise for you, in addition. I give you more than a dozen barrels of Sonreal, a wine normally reserved for the ducal table. The gustatory experience of a lifetime awaits. Are you content?
Nope. I can't wait! I'm truly honest. Got bad news, Sienna was out to kill you. Yeah, I said I'd tell her, so I'm gonna tell her. I'm gonna take this through to its conclusion, no matter what happens.
I am, and truly grateful, Your Grace. Sadly, I'm afraid I have to sour the mood. It's Sienna. She plotted to have you killed, Duchess. Planned to use Detloff. You were to be the Beast's fifth victim.
This cannot be true. You're mistaken. You must be.
I have proof.
I do not believe it.
Wow, okay. Damn, son. I mean, she is stubbornly not believing that.
In a moment, I shall speak to Sienna. Will you assist me? You returned my sister to me, yet what you tell me now, I find devastating. I've come to doubt that I can judge her fairly. I'd far prefer to learn you're mistaken, Geralt.
I'm not. In fact, I'd recommend you be particularly careful around her.
You exaggerate, Witcher. She is my sister. I know well how to speak to her.
Didn't speak
to her. If my presence will help in any manner, of course I'll stay.
We shall now question a person implicated in the murders which recently ravaged our fair city of Beauclair. Captain de la Tour, show Sylphia Anna in.
I thought Anna was the first name. Anna Henrietta, Henrietta being the family name. Apparently Henrietta is the first name and Anna is the family name. Who knew? You probably all knew, right? I just didn't. In fact, it makes no sense to me. But then, neither of those names as a family name makes sense to me.
The Witcher will take part in our talk.
She has one hand behind her back. I don't like the way that looks. I'm free to do as I choose.
I'm not a prisoner. Free to do as I choose.
You have committed crimes. Grave crimes. Yet you are my sister. And my heart does not allow me to treat you as a common criminal.
Nor does it let me believe you
sought my demise. My heart yearns to know you were swayed by the monster Detloff. You yourself would never stoop so low. Thus, I have asked Geralt to advise me, as one impartial. I shall now hear what he has to say.
Sienna's crimes are horrible, but she had cause to feel pain. Sienna's clearly guilty, that's all that matters. Well, see, that's the problem with me understanding all sides. She clearly had cause to feel pain, but it still doesn't excuse what she did, but because the first one is much more true than the second one, I kinda go with the first.
Bitterness consumes Sianna. She had cause to resent many of the court of Beauclair. I know her reasons, understand them even. But I can't condone the actions she chose to take.
What is he talking about, Sianna? You know exactly what. I was forcibly exiled, remember? To your benefit. You knew well the throne would then be yours, though I was the elder. The ministers, I can understand. They'd hated me since I was a child, thought me a poor prospect for the wife of a duke. I even understand our parents. I'd always sensed the problem. They simply feared me, for I dared to be free. That fabricated curse, it fell into their laps. A gift from above that brought relief. But you... your dagger hurt most. You were my Honorietta, dammit. My darling little sister. Now do you understand, Witcher? She betrayed me.
I knew that before. I knew that before. You said that. It's not new information for me. Oh, are we playing through this whole thing for everybody else's sake? I see.
Claim to understand them all? Why'd you come back for revenge? Have them all cut down then?
They deserved my vengeance. They detested me, all of them, as long as I can remember. But Honorietta understood me. Once.
Upon a time.
She was all I could cling to. Her betrayal hurt the most.
Bum bum bum.
You were children then. You and your sister both had no control over what happened.
You're wrong, Witcher. She had control. Remember, dear sister, the day they banished me from the palace. Of course, I'd had the idea to pelt the Nilfgaardian envoy with fish bladders, which we filled with rancid suet on a lark. And which you set afire at the last to impress me, I imagine. And I admit, you did. Hit him right in his hideous bald patch. Never laughed so hard in my life. But when it came time to find the culprit, you said not a word. I took all the blame and all the punishment.
It's true. I did not stand up for you. I was too afraid.
The council was unanimous. They listed all my offenses. My flights from the palace. Supposed acts of cruelty. Inappropriate friendships. They cast me out. But you, the only one to understand me, you cowered in a corner. Lifted not a finger to help. Not before. Not after. You never tried to find me.
That's not true. I searched for you. Sent out knights, gathered tidings from without. You did not wish to be found. Since the day you vanished, I have lived with the knowledge that I failed you. I'm sorry, dear sister. Can you forgive me?
Jesus effing Christ. She's the one who needs to be forgiven? I call bullshit. I call so much bullshit there. She gets the apology in the end? She? I do not agree. I don't agree. And I'm telling you right now, neither would the people. Not after she was to be blamed for the whole fucking town of Toussaint, village of Toussaint, whatever, being set ablaze by vampires. I'm telling you right now, it happened in reality. The Duchess would have a mob with burning sticks behind her right now.
All
I'm
no,
fucking certain
of
that.
Ceremony. It was short.
Perhaps for you, as you ducked out early. The others are probably just getting started. The drunkenness never ends in this quaint realm.
Not so fond of Toussaint after all, are we?
Oh, this place is like a strong wine, Geralt. Good in small sips.
You say that.
How do you find my personal brew? Not too strong.
Just right.
Credit the local mandrake of the Alrauna Diabolus variety for that. The tubers which grow in this area's volcanic soil have an altogether unique flavor profile and display a remarkably uncommon dark brown tint.
Fascinating. All I can say is this batch turned out excellent.
Indeed. It might be wise to stockpile some roots for the future. Would you care to accompany me?
Sort of what? Excuse me, you just went from all the celebration to... Doesn't my mandrake ale taste good? And there's another thing. Does such a thing like mandrake ale exist? And if so, does it taste good in any way, shape, or form? Because I can't imagine that. Still, I can't go over the fact that she forgave her sister in front of the entire fucking court. And they just went, instead of taking up their pitchforks and roasting them alive, both of them, on the spot. Sorry, I have a strong feeling about this, because she would not have been nearly so nice to anyone else on this entire fucking planet.
You decide to go root picking now? It's dark out.
Ugh, Geralt. Even were I generously to assume it had simply slipped your mind that I am a vampire and thus need no light to see, I'd never believe you had also forgotten that you likewise have absolutely no trouble seeing in the dark. So, shall we?
That's not true. I have to take a cat potion to see in the dark. I mean, Geralt has to. No, maybe Geralt is only doing this for our benefit. Who knows? He knows that we're sort of controlling him. Wouldn't that be meta? Sure. Fine, let's go.
If you think it's a good idea, let's go. But I think you might be forgetting one thing. Fresh mandrake root of this variety is highly toxic, even to a witcher.
Ah, not a problem. I never forget matters of safety and hygiene in alchemy. Here, gloves and a mask. Don them, and you shall be in no danger.
Thanks. Right then, let's go.
Let's pick some mandrake roots.
This moonlight makes.
And I'm gonna put on the stuff, of course. Not only will I put on the stuff, but as Geralt is a witcher through and through, I'll don my witcher gear to be somewhat more incognito. Where is the mask? What the fuck's that? Mandragora mask. Oh, right. I'm sort of looking for the right mask here. Oh, see that? Those are those stupid clothes that you just wear. There we go. Mask for picking mandrake, which looks like a pestilence mask that the doctors wore. Did it have any helpful effect during the Black Plague? I can't remember. I seriously can't. Where are the gloves? The fuck are the gloves? Are you shitting me now? Are they under quest items as well? Oh, yes, they are. Okay, fine. There we go.
Oh, so dreamy.
Penny for your thoughts. Let me guess. Succubus twins?
No, I was thinking about... Oh, how anything can look interesting when properly lit.
Even an old necrophage corpse?
You've not an ounce of refinement in you, have you?
Nope. Well, sure he has, but he's... Despite everybody... Everybody believing to the opposite? Did I say that right? He's quite a funny dude. He has an immense sense of humor. Even if it's a bit of a dry one. With a bit of a dead sense of humor. Am I just... Oh, I'm supposed to collect two as well. I see. Cool. Here's the first one. And... The second one should not be too far. Jacob de Chamois. Neither drank nor smoke, yet still up and died. Good riddance, made a profitably able to give him a noogie in the afterlife. Mandrake root shouldn't be so... Ah, there we go. That's the second one. What you want to guess that Reaches is gone? Rich is just gone.
Now, where'd that bloodsucker go? Won't be easy to track down. He's a vampire, after all.
I'm gonna tell you, that was...
Regis!
That was Regis's way to simply fuck off. What do you want to bet? That Regis didn't want to say goodbye? And that he sort of has troubles to work through with after all the deadlift thing? And, you know...
Damn it, where'd you go?
That was just his way of...
Regis!
Well, leaving, basically. Holy fuck of fucks. Ooh, boy! What the hell is going on? He's quite proficient in killing lower vampires. I can't really do anything here. It says help Regis defeat the vampires, but he's one-shotting them all. Quite impressively so.
Those Bruxay, they called you a traitor.
Alas, we've a very simple code of honor, we vampires. So simple you might call it trivial. Either one is with us, unconditionally, regardless of the circumstances, or...
Won't let it go, will they?
They will not. Fortunately, we've another rule, an unwritten one, and just as trivial as the first. It is neatly summarized in the saying, out of sight, out of mind. That is why I must leave Toussaint, for a vastly long time, most like.
Yeah, I get it.
Let us make for my camp. I've an overwhelming desire to have another drink.
I see, so he's gonna skedaddle because they want to kill him, but if he leaves Toussaint, they go, well, fuck it, he's gone. At least he's not following us.
Supreme bouquet. Firm, defined beginning, then develops gently, rising to a startling finish. Don't you think?
You know what
not
I'm
much
thinking?
Of a connoisseur.
Then it is high time you started your education. After all, the Corvo Bianco vineyard is now yours. By the way, I left a gift for you at your new home, on the nightstand.
Thanks. Mind telling me what it is?
A trifle. That will nonetheless be useful should you need mutagens. Incidentally, have you thought about what you'll do with your prize? Shall you hang your swords over the mantle and take to pruning vines?
That's a good question, isn't it? Oh, and I think that's another one of those... That's another one of those questions that the game asks you that could be meta. That could be just a, do you want another Witcher game, or are you fine with it? And quite honestly, for Geralt's sake, I think he should settle down and leave it be, maybe find somebody. But... First of all, I want to see another Witcher game, whether or not it's gonna happen. I don't think it's gonna happen, but we'll see. And... I don't think they'll let him ever settle down. Might be okay with him for a short time, but after a while I think they'll get tired of him and they'll, you know, will cause all kinds of trouble for him. Maybe somebody else is asking him to kill a monster, some contract, some land far, far away that smells like adventure. You know, Geralt has to do his thing the same way, the same way the Rolling Stones are doing it. Playing till they drop on the stage. Same for him.
No, just not the life for me. Sure, might stop by there occasionally, stay the winter, fill up on wine. But I'd rather keep moving. It's not a choice being a Witcher. And once you are one, you're one for life. You can't just step off the path. Besides, plenty of work left for me in the world. Ghouls aren't gonna kill themselves.
Rather droll, isn't it, that each time we meet, something harrowing must happen? I can remember a night, not too far from here, if I'm not mistaken. We hid in a cave while a blizzard raged all about. Does that sound at all familiar?
Sounds like an interesting story.
We just set off to rescue Ciri from Vilgefortz.
Oh, our encounter with Vilgefortz. That is something I do not remember so fondly. But that first stay in Beauclair, far calmer than this one.
Seemed like a land straight out of a fairy tale back then. Its sole problem, cellars too small to accommodate all that wine.
Appearances, Geralt. Appearances like Mamoons and Dopplers deceive. So what did become of Vilgefortz?
Killed him. Sure wasn't easy, though.
Did you? Man, that sounds like an interesting story I'd like to see.
What about you? Any idea where you'll go?
Distance is of the essence. I thought I might venture south.
Nilfgaard?
I thought we are in Nilfgaard.
The Nilfgaardians are a modern society. None there believe in vampires anymore. This fact alone could be very useful to one wishing to remain incognito.
Interesting point of view.
Zeracania would be something I'd like to see.
I so don't feel like going anywhere. Sit here a while longer?
So we shall, my friend. We have witnessed, and in fact on several occasions incited, many great and weighty events. After all that toil, I believe we deserve a bit of a rest.
That we do.
Of course, the last thing is he's looking exactly at the camera. You know what? I'm sorry I'm gonna go the whole meta route again, but that felt like the developers telling us, you know, it's been a wild ride, we had a lot of fun, but you sort of need a break, you know? But, oh my god, could that mean that they want to make another Witcher game? They just really want to take a break now after having made three Witcher games and sort of revisiting it later after they bring out Cyberpunk 2077, which we still don't know fuck all about except for the trailer they've brought out, and that it's supposedly gonna be bigger, not necessarily in terms of the world, but in terms of well, yes, the world, but not as in more hours to play is what I understood, but more on the along the lines of just even more detailed, even more intricate, even more, you know, just immersive. Immersive is the good word for that. Immersive is a very good word for that. So that's the end of The Witcher 3. That's the end we got. I have no idea which one it is. It didn't look like a catastrophic end, I gotta say. I don't think, though, it was the best ending you could get, because I wasn't happy with it. Maybe it's just me bitching on a very high level, or a too low a level. Who knows? I mean, maybe everybody else just go, oh, forgive Sianna, and forgive Henrietta, everything's cool because they're in charge and so they should be happy, but I don't know. Anyway, if you like to see the other endings, write it in the comments. I'll be happy to oblige. As far as I know, there are three, right? That's what I heard, three endings. I'm gonna have to look up how to get to those. I know that I'm probably gonna get a different ending if I go to Orianna, but I have no idea if it's gonna play out or how to get the third ending. But guess we'll see. I guess you can help me out in the comments on this one, because after I've now done the ending that I sort of chose myself, we can go after the other two, if you want to, and I'll be absolutely up to that. Alternatively, or not actually alternatively, okay, if you don't want the endings, which sort of, I mean, Kiss and Run already said he'd like to see the other two endings, so I might just do that anyway, but I am going to I really don't feel comfortable making any kind of promises at this point, because past has shown that I can't really keep them a lot of the times, because it turns out that having two games at the same time, like trying to upload two videos a day, is really hard for me, since I'm not even capable of uploading one video every day. Now the problem with that was mostly because I tried to be so recent that I played it on the same day, rendered it, uploaded it, and so, you know, that I could get potential feedback. But because of this process, there were a lot of days in that time span that I played The Witcher 3 that I just that was physically incapable of getting to my computer and you know, making an episode happen. So there were quite a few days. Recently, there was like 5 days in a span of 10 where I couldn't make videos. I'm sorry about that. So I don't like feel comfortable promising more than one video a day. In fact, one video a day. Well, I'm still gonna try. Like, I'm gonna try my best, right? But seeing as this really is only a hobby's hobby, really. The job and the studies sort of have to take precedence. I'm sorry about that, really. But I do want to. I mean, you've seen there is GTA 5. I decided now to not show all the side quests, because that's just ridiculous. That all those little side events, if they're not interesting, they're not really interesting. I'm just sort of concentrating on the main story. I'm gonna play it a bit on the side myself. All the side shit I'm gonna do off camera. Makes more sense. I'm also gonna try to cut down on the whole traveling time when we're just getting towards a location. A mission starter location. You've seen that on the last GTA episode. It's been a while since I've uploaded a GTA. Then I still have Deus Ex. I'm not quite sure how I'm gonna handle that yet, because I know if I do a non-lethal, there's gonna be a lot crawling around in vents and stuff. That's not gonna be interesting. I'm gonna have to see how I'm gonna cut that. Maybe it doesn't work at all, and we're not gonna do this for very long, the whole Deus Ex. It's totally dependent on you. Of course, I've got a few other ideas for series. Your ideas are always welcome. I'm always gonna have a look at them. Of course, naturally, I prefer games that I haven't played myself. Because, well, yeah, that's just the way I am. I enjoy being like new to the whole thing. So if it's a game already played, I might do it on a stream when they are gonna happen again. Again, you know, not promising much. Maybe next week there's gonna be a stream. Yeah. Is there something else I wanted to talk about? I don't really think so. If you've listened to me through all this babble, there's one thing I do want to say. I love the ending. I really do love the ending of how it just... It's... You know, I can see how you do a very action-style ending after a part if you know there's another one coming. But if it's the end of a trilogy, which it is in this case, and if it's maybe the last Witcher game ever, and if not, then at least the last Witcher game for the next... probably five to six, seven years, maybe longer. Then it's a really nice ending to have them just to have two old acquaintances, to have your main characters sit with an old acquaintance and just sort of rest a bit and be sort of done with all the stress, relax a little bit. Reminisce about the old days. And who knows? maybe if there's gonna be a witch in the future, and if it's gonna be about Geralt, we'll see him at exactly that point, you know, talking to Regis about the good old days, and then we're gonna get transported to the good old days. Who knows? Maybe we'll have old Geralt? Or there's my idea of going all together with the beginning of the Witcher era, where the whole, with the first Witchers, and when they figure out how to do signs, and figuring out how silver is the best against monsters, and seeing like fantastic monsters that by the time the Witcher series plays have long been extinct. You know, shortly after the conjunction of spheres, that's what they said, what it's called. I'm still talking over the whole credits, by the way. I mean, you're fully welcome to click them away or to close the window or whatever, but I feel like I have to do CD Projekt Red justice by letting the entire credits run through till the end, and in fact sort of, I mean, I would have watched them anyway, but I feel like, oops, what the fuck's going on? Well, that was my screensaver. I didn't think it would engage when I was actually watching something. That is a bit weird. I'll be honest, it's a bit weird. Anyway, so, yeah. Letting the whole credits run through and making an... Maybe the credits are going to be an entire video of their own. Who knows? You can skip that totally. I'm going to put like... it's not really a channel update, but something a bit channel-y into the title. Who knows? Anyway, I think this is one of the game that deserves its credits to be like displayed in full after watching the game in full, playing the game in full. Phew, that's a lot of people, right? So now that we've been properly introduced, we'd like to thank you one last time. Blood and Wine is the end of The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. We wanted to call it Sweat and Tears, or damn, we'll miss this. But we couldn't! Oh my god, that was so fast! In loving memory of Carolina Grzechowska. I think they had the same in loving memory thing at the credits of the last one. I still don't know who she is, but she seems very young.
Actually, I'd love to go home.
All right. New quest, be it ever so humble. Go home. Right, they said, and I totally forgot, or Regis said, and totally forgot that, that he left a little present for Geralt, helping him with his mutation. I certainly want to have a look at that. Can't leave without seeing it.
And what do you get for all that work?
Oh, there we go.
Master Witcher, some unknown individual barged into the residence. I resisted as best I could. But to no avail.
Who is it?
Alas, they did not do me the basic courtesy of introducing themselves.
It's gonna be Yennefer. I hope it's Yennefer. Would make sense. A bit brash.
What's that smell?
Lilac and gooseberries. That's how the game started. That's how The Witcher started. The Witcher 3, sorry about that. So what you wanna bet I'm right? Oh, I'm gonna be right, am I not? Oh, balls, I am not.
You look good. Come, don't just stand there. I want a hug.
Serious Beck, woo! She probably has her own adventure. That's a way of doing another Witcher game.
What did you bring?
A falling Serious Star. I slew it, all by my lonesome.
That why you left Carrera so suddenly? Had no idea where you'd gone. Your note was puzzling. Don't try to find me. Threw me for a loop.
That was silly. It's just that I felt stifled in your shadow. I'd have suffocated had I stayed.
Oh wow, that's nice.
So when I read that notice, the contract, when I saw Angren, I knew I had to do it. Alone. Without my nanny.
I'm not your nanny. I believe in you.
Grin.
Like my new house?
The house is lovely, but it could use a bit of work.
What?
Yeah, got plans for it, don't worry. Wanna go outside? Could show you the grounds.
No, it can't. It's fully upgraded. Don't diss my home. I'm gonna have problems right there if you diss my home. Wow, you totally miss that if you just turn off the game. I guess you can't. You just can't skip the credits.
It's lovely here. I could stay forever.
You could, and I'd take off for adventures. Not sexist at all. I thought you'd like it.
What's stopping you?
Actually, not a thing. I slew a Garkin, collected my bounty. I believe I'm owed some respite.
Indeed you do, mademoiselle, as my majordomo would say.
You've a butler?
A steward. Name's Barnabas Basil. BB for short, though I don't know if he likes it. He's the one let you in. I'll ask him to bring in some fruit, a beverage. You can spend the rest of the day lying about.
Nothing would make me happier.
I mean, Basil has gotta think all kinds of things to himself now. Two white-haired, fully armor-clad dudes with swords. I mean, okay, dude didn't do that, but still.
Being a witcher, anything like you imagined?
Geralt, I didn't have to imagine anything. Remember, before we parted, we walked a good stretch of the path together.
Yeah, but that's
journeyman and master, though, not the same thing.
Not even
I'm
close.
I'm still a long way from mastering anything, but I am trying. Anyway, I did learn from the best.
Just passed on what worked for me, or at least tried to.
I was thinking of Eskel and Lambert.
Sure you did.
So, no regrets? Choice you made?
Not at all. I'm doing what I ever wanted to do. Being who I wanted to be. I believe that's one definition of happiness.
Yeah, that's my definition of happiness, actually. Nothing about money. I just want to be who I am and do what I like to do. Not that it worked out so far, for the most part, but I'm working on it.
Encountered the most charming aspect of being a witcher yet?
Which aspect is that?
The hatred, disgust, that strange blend of admiration, fear, and contempt.
They set their hands on me in one village. In another, they forbade me from taking a drink from their well. Other than that, it's been all right. No one's tried to cheat me out of my reward so far.
Guess you've
I'd hope they'd treat a woman differently.
Geralt, when they treat a woman differently in this world, it hardly ever means better. Quite the opposite.
Yeah. Yeah. You probably also got less reward than Geralt got for his contracts. Because they don't trust a woman can do the job. I mean, that's still the way it is. In some parts.
Engrin, how'd it go? Garkanes can be pretty tough opponents.
That's why I had to lure this one to a place both spacious and empty, where it would have nowhere to hide. I found an abandoned crypt far from any town or village.
Good choice. Always best to avoid additional casualties, so your foe had nowhere to hide. But the bastard was still damn quick, I bet.
Not as quick as I am. My greater worry was its strength. I was far outclassed there. But a dose of black blood did the trick. We fought a while, I feigned a mistimed dodge and let it drink. The rest was easy.
That's actually good. That's a good tactic. I did that too with the Broxay. Broxay? What's the other one called? Alp. Yeah, I know it was Broxay.
See you later, Siri.
Take care of yourself.
Be it ever so humble. Complete.
Oh, wow. Okay. So now I'm gonna check out my present. What's that? In the living room. Oh, in the sleeping room? Sleeping room? We can call it sleeping room. Ah, look at this. There we go. Muta generator. What the fuck? Oh, That's not what I wanted to do at all. A letter from Regis. Dear Geralt, if you are reading these words, I mean I am already far beyond the borders of Toussaint, and you have found my mutagenerator. Of course, you may dub this instrument however you like, perhaps some more fitting to your taste or better reflecting its function, for I have no doubt your knowledge on the subject of mutagen is far more profound and thorough than mine. I have been working on this device in my spare time, but now it is finished, and I am convinced as an inventor can be before his invention has been used as intended, of the usefulness of this apparatus. You're surely wondering what function it is meant to serve. As the name indicates, the mutagenerator generates mutagens. It operates by absorbing electromagnetical energy waves from bodies. What? In this case, the bodies of the monsters and evildoers you kill. Oh, look at this! And when it has absorbed enough so as to be charged a critical amount, the mutagenerator changes the stored energy into a greater mutagen, which I suspect you will make good use of. I would if I hadn't had an endless supply of these, well, not of the greater ones, but of the smaller ones. As you surely understand, I am an amateur engineer, which is why you must forgive the lack of an ability for you to direct this operation. Which mutagen emerges as a result is determined at random, meaning chance will decide if it is green, red, or blue, or some weird mixture of them. Yet I have noted the colors tend to alternate by and large. I trust you shall find my gift useful. Your dearly devoted friend, Emil Regis Roylock, whatever. You might be wondering why I decided to toss the mutagenerator into your home instead of simply handing it to you in person. Well, you must know, I did it out of modesty. Believe it or not, take care, Geralt, and may my gift serve you well. I don't think we'll get to try it out, but I'll have a look at it. It should be under quest items, right? What would you do with it? Oh, what is this? Shalemar trophy, okay. That's useless. Device for creating mutagens. It needs 100 charges, so you need to kill 100 things before you get one greater mutagen. Well, okay. If that is what you think is best, then... Oh, Marlene. Of course, we've got a cook. I totally forgot that. We have a... What the fuck? Did she actually... How did she get all that clutter into my place? It's standing in front of my armor. I do not appreciate that.
How might I be off?
It's just one question. Is it? Oh, right. I never played Gwent Thanks. Against Majordomo. Well, I guess we'll never do now. So, that's it for this episode. That's it for this game. That's it for me. With the exception of, you know, the other endings, potentially. So, have a nice day. Have a nice night. I hope you're doing well. I hope you're doing really good. And, well, all the best to you. Bye!